also have, which would be lovely for you. Hi, Richie.
Hey, Howard, introduce you to Richie.
Okay.
Hi.
Hi, Richie.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm great.
Good to see you again.
How you doing, Brenda?
I'm good.
Good.
This is your friend Bob.
Hi, friend Bob.
Richie, how are you? Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you too, Bob.
If you wanna sit over here, I'll go get your beer.
Gee. Yeah, it looks like more regal.
You want to?
Regal.
Oh, yeah.
Should I ask regal?
How about Buick Regal?
The chairs are very regal.
Howard, are you losing weight?
I hope so. I don't know, am I? Let's see, that's the way to, greet an old friend with a compliment like that. Thank you. Hi, everybody.
You on the keto diet too?
Hi, everybody. It's me again. I'm here with Bimo Sabi.
Go Bills!
Welcome to,
go Bills!
Welcome to another edition of Lounge Academy. This is our 11th year, our 4-million episode. Tonight we're going to be doing that show regulars. Brent, wait, let me put the right mic on. I can do this now. Okay, this is great. Now we're talking. Okay, take two. We're here with show regular lounge cadet Brenda, home favorite.
Hi, Howard.
And she brought
Bob.
Bob from high school.
Yes.
You'll be back.
That's
first.
from the Ohio, from high schools. The Hamburg.
Yes, Hamburg.
Yes. And anyway, they're going to be at their VIP table. We got home favorite Richie Sellers with us tonight.
Go Bills.
He's got his game face on for the Bills.
Yeah. All right.
Look like he could play on the Bills. Richie stays in shape. He wrestles horses.
He's only 27.
He's a horse guy. That's why he's in shape. Anything to do with horses keeps you in shape.
That's right.
Keeps you broke, too.
I saw the horses race at Saratoga Monday.
That was a terrific trip to Saratoga.
It was great. I loved it. A fantastic time.
I saw it. We were following your action.
Oh, you did?
Brenda.
Saw my pictures?
And we saw you. It looked like you were doing a lot of relaxing.
I did.
So it looked like a recreational trip.
It was very nice. Went to the lake. To see a lot of old friends. It's really nice.
It looked like you were having a lot of fun.
Good to be back, though.
It's great to have you back.
Thank you.
Tonight we're going to be operating under actual lounge conditions with low lighting, thanks to Connor, who makes this all possible.
How are you?
That's the big guy. He waved to me, and he used all five fingers, so that's... That's good. That's all you want.
That's right.
From Connor.
All five.
You know, yes. All five at once.
Right.
All in one hand.
Yes. And then life is good. Oh, we got things all set up. I'm going to check to see if we're really, really transmitting here. Uh-oh, Ryan. Where's our stream?
No, I can't make it every week.
Bob and Richie are getting acquainted.
I'm working just down the road.
That's what this reality piano bar is all about. Unwitting. Unwitting players. We're getting a lousy signal here for some reason, which is... A little concerning. There's always two slow feet per second. Okay, well, we're just going to have to keep our fingers crossed that the signal improves, because everything's as good as we can do for this. And other than the signal not working at the moment, we've got, everything else seems to be working good. We've got our split cams going. See if I can pull in the signal to see our, here we go. I see Brenda on TV. Okay, we're, this is where the sausage is, of show business is made here. This isn't a very good picture, is it? Here comes, we're gonna get a shot of Brenda coming down with her drink. This is real live reality TV. Those are real drinks, and that's really Brenda. We take anything, Richie. IOUs are fine. Brenda's sitting down with high school chum Bob from Hamburg. And they both have a birthday almost around the same day. So they can celebrate it together, which is really nice. And what a privilege it is for Lounge Academy to be a part of these historic events, which are always being played out here at the Statler. We actually get spoiled by historic events going on every time we're here, people getting married, sometimes for the first time. Yeah. A couple guys coming in and after a hard week's work to do some damage up in the lobby bar. And here we go. Here comes some home favorites, Barbara Fisher. We've got Gary Marino and Frederick. So this is big. Nice to see you, Mr. Marino.
Nice to be seen.
I mean Marino. I get to call him just Marino.
Right.
Frederick, how are you, sir?
Hello, everyone. Who's there? Ciao.
Ciao.
Wow, this is, we're off to some good real reality piano bar, real drama, Barbara Fisher, right off the start. As you all know, who've been following Lounge Academy, Frederick and Brenda met at Lounge Academy. A couple of months ago here. And had a famous summer until about 2 weeks ago when it all came crashing down right here, right on reality TV, And as you can see, everybody's great despite that. And you know, these songs we all love here from the golden era of the great shows and musicals play out that sort of drama as the live soundtrack to the relationships throughout our lives. And, well, I guess we should, what do you think, Barbara Fisher and Barry? Nice to see you, Barry. We got Mr. Otto with us. Wonderful, sir. Wonderful to see you. Well, let's get to work. As you can see, we've got.
I missed Thursday. I didn't know.
They're talking about show business, ladies and gentlemen, discussing the movies. This new gear, it took me 12 weeks to build it all. That's why I'm really happy about this love triangle situation at the VIP table, because 12 weeks is a lot of work to put into equipment to be able to bring reality piano bar to all the home cadets. Want is to have a dud, you know, with no drama. I'll give you some of the split screen action. I've got another surprise camera for you guys too. Watch this. VIP table cam, just introducing at this moment. Our technology is an embarrassment of riches. Here. We got some real piano bar reality going on. How's the audio at home, anybody? Just as a final check, it's good to hear from the cadets to give me a thumbs up on the audio. Thank you. half, nonstop. Playing. Yeah. Nice group. Nice group of people. Beautiful wedding. And the house called. Yeah. It's nice to see you, Frederick. Looking good. Mr. Show Business to everybody at home. Interesting people in a live stream. Just a little bit like this. Keys. Doesn't get any more exotic than that. I've got another phone. Jenkins. How's Grand Island treating everybody? Oh, yeah, I gotta peel that off before it kills the tree or something. Popping up here on my. No, I think that was just the last. It's regurgitating the last message I sent to Ryan several days ago. down in Buffalo's historic Statler Hotel. We're celebrating Brenda's birthday tonight. And the birthday of her old lifelong friend, Bob, from high school. Spot at the VIP table, you get here first, or you bribe the maitre d'. Oh, who's mine? Well, thank you. What did I do? We went, she took me out to dinner. She paid. Oh yeah, it's win-win. No, we went out for sushi. Yeah, we ate it raw. I love sushi, it was my idea. It's a beautiful day. Janetville, because she's got lots of alligators smiling back at her. They're not showing their teeth. Here she comes now, ladies and gentlemen. Star of the show, Mary Kunz Goldman. How are you, Mary?
Good, Howard. Happy to see everyone tonight. I see Rich, Super Frederick, Gary, Brenda. We'll stand and recite the doxology.
Work in the crowd. She's a wonderful host, of course.
This heart of mine was doing very well. The world was fine. As far as I could tell, suddenly I met you, and I dreamed of gay amour. Dawn, I woke up singing sentimental overtures. This heart of Maureen's and her sister. Sister Linda. Her sister Linda is even a better singer. It's unbelievable, the talent in that family. Did your brother fly you here? How pedestrian. Chair. He knows what to do. He sees a lady, he gets a place for her to set herself down. People have a few drinks with this group here. You're going to be keeping the bar bartender busy tonight, I can tell. All the swingers are toasting each other over at the VIP table. This is how things are done at Lounge Academy. Janet, which camera do you want to see? You guys could direct the show. I'll put the multicam on here. For those just tuning in, you're watching Lounge Academy on WBIG-TV, Buffalo's choice of 25. We're at the piano here with Richie Sellers. Ryan's in Chicago. I forgot he told me he was getting on a plane. Shout out to Ryan. Well, let's give Ryan Lysars, ladies and gentlemen, using our new shout out feature. There he is. See that? Zach and Jim Corbin, founding member. Long winded.
Is Ryan doing that?
No, I did it right here, Richie. Oh, like that. Who cares with your whips on mine? sister Linda?
Thank you.
do, but I kind of got my hands full. Oh, go ahead and enjoy it, Richie. It's a great town, Cindy Chan. Top right. Top right, that's this one. This is for Janet. She didn't request a song, she requested a camera angle. This goes out to Florida Keys.
You are the product. person. You're part of the show. You're the most interesting part of the show. We've got some real drama going on over here at the VIP table. Brenda's back. Some more drama going on here, but we haven't gotten to the bottom of it yet. A few more drinks, it'll make it a little easier to get the truth. This camera angle has been brought to us by Janet down in the Florida Keys. We're going to switch it up a little bit now. Go back to the multi-cam angle. Well, you can request some camera angles if you want. Cheer everybody up. This song will cheer up all the couples. These songs are very bipolar. You're either very happy or things aren't going well at all. Shine, and the thrill is gone. I'm afraid the masquerade is over. Just routine. I'm afraid the masquerade is over, and so is love. Songs, Richie. You can just get lost in them. Maybe we'll do some random search and destroy. We're going to just set this over here so it can tease me. You know what? We'll do some search and destroy out of here. You know, or we could do some out of here. Awesome. The
one. We have to pull people back from the brink after those last ones. Here's one that everybody seems to be able to relate to, strangely. I guess it kind of makes sense. We've all been there, Richie. Paul wanted to get even, right? They say Johnny Mercer wrote with, like, everybody that would ask him, he'd write lyrics for him. He was very democratic about that. And then I'm glad he said yes to Sadie Vimmerstedt, whose work I'm not familiar with, but she wrote a heck of a song. Now we got this great song. Start in the A's. I forgot I got one. A ventriloquist taught me how to do this. Again.
couldn't happen again. This is that once in a lifetime. The mundane sounding Bobby Burger, but they've also got exotic things like blocks of wood, you know, that you could gnaw on if you want, and they have fancy names. They used to have fancy names. They made it simple. Cheese and mead. Well, mead is a fancy word. Not meat, mead. I don't even know what that is. Cheese and mead board. And you get this beautiful plank. It's like a cutting board. And you don't get to keep that. But you could do whatever you want with it while it's rented in front of you. It looks delicious. Parmesan truffle tater tots. That's Mary likes those. The Parmesan truffle tater tots, $9. And that's, get them before the supply interruptions because they're coming. And they'll either not have it or they'll be market rate like lobster. Statler chicken fingers. At first I thought it was a fancy French word because I couldn't read it. But it's just fingers. Yeah. Which I appreciate as a musician. Statler chicken fingers served with French fries and blue cheese dressing. And that's spelled just like the color blue. They could have got fancier with that, right, Rich? Yeah. They didn't though. Philly cheesesteak, flatbread pizza. That might be what this
tasted. Somebody tipped me with a slice of. We've got samples to show people. This is the cheese and pepperoni without the pepperoni. They'll make it any way you want. Flat. This is the flatbread. It's so flat you can't even see it over the ridge, over the rim of this plate, because it's flatbread. It's not old at all. It's from tonight, and I'm looking forward to eating it. And that's topped with house-made marinara sauce, grated mozzarella, and hand-sliced pepperoni, which you can delete. It's a delete option. My half, you should have put the pepperoni on, Richie. Gelato dessert, strawberry salad. The strawberry salad, Mary's had that. The strawberry salad. It's only $120. $12. With almond-crusted goad. Good or goad? Goad cheese, balsamic dressing. So, these things are all available. They're not always available because sometimes there's big events going on and the kitchen is going nuts trying to feed like 500 people. So, we graciously give up the right to eat on those nights. But tonight, you could order. I know I'm gonna. And you could have that satisfied look like Richie has right now. Just a dream or two, but I've got lots of plans for tomorrow. All my tomorrow belong to you. Right now it may not seem like spring at all. Window, we're drifting, and the laughs are few. But I've got rainbows planned for tomorrow. All my tomorrows belong to you. No one knows better than that luck keeps passing me by. That's fate. But with you there by my side, we'll still be turning the tide. Just wait. As long as I've got arms that cling at all, I'll be clinging to all I dream, beg and borrow. All my tomorrows, they all come true. All my bright tomorrows a surprise, but it's kind of a surprise. Kathy Moses, ladies and gentlemen. How about another big round of applause for Kathy Moses? She's married to the famous Nick Moses. Is Nick following up?
of a competition about you can drink Mari under the table for whatever. They're very competitive in that family. They're like the Kennedys. They're all great at everything. Or else. That's what we do at Lounge Academy, because this is Lounge Academy reality piano bar. It's reality TV, so we delve into the personal lives of our audience because they are the show. Without interesting lounge cadets, we'd be nothing. Kathy's heading up to the bar now. She knows where it is. We need Barbara Fisher so we can try out another new feature I built. It's Frank DeCesare. He stopped to say, hey. Ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. From Southern Florida. It's not far from Janet. Are you very far from the Keys? Frank, do you realize you're kind of close to Janet? In a propinquity way, I mean. Checking in from YYZ. Song obscure, but probably most people don't know it. Ooh, here I go again. I hear those trumpets blow again. I'm all aglow again. Taking a chance on love. Here I slide again. I'm about to take that ride again. Starry-eyed again, taking a chance on love. They say the game was a frame-up. I never would try. Now they're picking that game up, and the ace of hearts is high. Things are mending now. I see the rainbows blending now. We'll have that happy ending now. Taking a chance on love. Oh yeah, yeah. Taking that chance on love. everybody. Tip sign for the home viewers and it won't turn off. Oh, here we go. Thank you.
Keith and Schwartz. Thank you, Mari. I mean, McNeil. And the Buffalo News refers to Mari McNeil as McNeil. She's on a first name basis, like Cher. If you just tuned in, you're watching Lounge Academy. Broadcast live from Buffalo's historic Statler Hotel. Co-hosted by Gary Marino. Proprietor of Casa de Marino. Very hip little jazz club on Buffalo's east side. But hopefully he's going to throw me an after party tonight. Never spellbound by a starry sky. What is there to move? Love has passed you by. Then there came a midnight. Just by you. Anybody know what song this is? At last, my love has come along. My lonely days are over. Like a song. Thank you. was the synchronization. Gotta test the synchronization every once in a while. Not too bad. Okay. Gotta make sure that. Mr. Gruff, what a pleasure to see you, sir.
How are you?
Good. How are you? Nice to see you.
So glad I made it.
How are you? Good to see you.
Yeah, how are you doing? All right. Sounds great. You're here every Friday.
Fridays.
Fridays, okay. Great.
It's a lot of fun.
What's that?
It's a lot of fun. We're live streaming.
Is that right? Jeez. Hi, everybody.
Exclusive. Look, I could even like work the mixer and everything. Ladies and gentlemen, we're here with showbiz Mr. Show Business, Jay Lewis Dreff.
Hi, everyone.
Who's really I feel like he's family because his aunt is so close.
Met, this is the second time I think we've met in person. But
I think it is. I think I met you at a big show business event where you were unveiling a movie.
That's right.
Yeah.
The Joe Giambra.
Which was a great movie.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
And that was a lot of fun. Yeah.
That sure was.
It's a great spot. Yeah.
Yeah, you know, what you can do it. It's the best looking room I was able to find under the circumstances.
Yeah. I hear they're closing again to do some remodeling.
I know. They are. Yeah. James. I guess after January 1, we're going to have to...
What's that?
After January 1, we're going to have to, like...
Find a new spot?
Hide out for a year or two.
Okay.
You know.
Wow.
But
it's so
we were always at my place, you know, for this.
Yeah.
I did cocktail piano here for 10 years.
Okay.
And then when it reopened, I decided and found out it was going to close.
Right.
I figured, this is it. You know, I brought the Lounge Academy concept over here.
Yeah.
So I get to do my vocalizing, which I know you feel threatened about, but that's okay. That's a good competitive spirit.
Yeah.
That's a good competitive. It'll bring more out of you.
I love your videos. I love those videos.
Well, thank you.
On Facebook. Those are
thank
great.
You. Well, I like yours too. That are quite actually good, very inspiring. But yeah. They're either, I'm not sure if they're either inspiring or they make me just want to completely quit altogether.
Stop.
It's one way or the other. If I survive them, it's inspiring.
They're great, yeah. It sounds like you're having a lot of fun, so that's good.
We are. You know? We're doing that.
Yeah.
As long as I'm having fun, that's all that matters.
Yeah.
You know.
Good. Well, one of these days we should collaborate. We should do a song together.
Well, we should. We will. We will. Let's figure out one that, I know how singers are. They got their keys.
Yeah.
And stuff. So we'll work.
You know,
we'll just agree on something.
You know Autumn Leaves?
If I got it, we could do it. I think it's in G, isn't it? Or do you do it in like C sharp minor? Now let me see if see if I got it. So I'll be playing something out. As long as I know how it's supposed to sound, it's not as good as sharp and flat. How are you, sir? Nice to see you guys. Something great. Something the world has not heard quite like this. Books because I don't know how to read. That's a good book because they're pretty much it. Easy.
I'm going to sing for, I'm going to sing for Jay while he's finding his song. Here's one. This is a great way to introduce the song, isn't it? Say, here's one.
Yeah.
This is the end. Did you ever have a friend and then... Did you ever have a friend that you were just going to be friends with? And then, like, 10 drinks later and something happens?
Jay, are you
going
to
sing?
I'm going to sing.
Not
I'm not seeing my music in here.
See, these singers, you guys are
a million songs.
It all comes down to this. Finding it in the right key, the right key. McNeil's got some amazing keys. 15 flats.
Women
peace. I guarantee there's good stuff in that. The easy reader.
Jay, your license is it Dreyfus?
Dreyfus.
Okay, this is you got to get this part right.
Show business audience like we have here tonight. It's because you understand the pain of the creative process. That brings more out of me. Is that right, Jay? Do you play for musicians and show business people? Any kind of that gives. This creativity is creativity. Artists.
You know what I got one I think for you.
Okay.
My Funny Valentine.
Right.
I think I got it. Okay.
Too late.
Is that right? This is Rogers and Hart, you know.
Rogers are up there. We discovered him.
Here's the Joe.
Yeah.
Joe.
Joe.
Yeah.
Joe. Yeah. Joe. 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 Joe.
Joe. Joe.
Joe. Joe. Joe.
Joe.
Joe. Joe. Joe. Joe. Joe. Joe.
Can I get this mic or?
Hey, that was much better, Jay.
Jay Lewis Strife, ladies and gentlemen.
It's not the pale moon that excites me, that thrills and delights me. Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. It isn't your sweet conversation that brings this sensation. Oh, no. It's just the nearness of you. When you're in my arms, and I feel so close to me, all my wildest
He's a genius, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, he is. I collect geniuses. I marry them, too. But that is not a proposal. There's a charity raffle tomorrow. Auction.
Something was doing
for a radio station. Jay's friends are heading back up to the bar. Seeing. And then if they don't see me, they bump into the piano bench to make sure I'm there. Lounge cadets are so nice to me. My gas tank thanks you. The night is like a lovely tune. Let's put this on a more interesting subject. have to do everything around here. Operate the cameras. Drink cans of pop. Take two. The night is like a lovely tune. He knows them all.
No, I get cluttered. Sometimes.
He knows it. No, I know. That's why. So do I. That's why I went to threw it to you. Here's one: Bob Hilliard and David Mann. Thank you. lips next to mine. So I kissed them. You didn't mind it at all. When I'm away, such a break never happens. How long can a guy go on dreaming? If there's a chance that you care, then please say you do, my baby. Say it and make my crazy dreams come true. Listening to me. I used to have an audience that's listening. Bob's got his own show going over here. He's quick. Should have known. That's how they roll in Hamburg. I don't think they're going to get rid of the Skyway. I think they're going to keep that thing. We need it. It leads right here. Wider than a mile, a
pacing round the bed. Huckleberry Friend, Moon River. Wherever she goes, they play her in with that song. Have a great evening, everybody. Get your fish fries tonight. Have a great week. Thanks for visiting the staff. Her history is made every day. It's a fact. I saw a guy get married 3 times here. You.
I'll move the mountains. And I'll move the mountains. If she wants them out of the way. That's the way it is, right? Crazy, she calls me. Thanks, everybody. This is the distillation of a great Lounge Academy crowd. I love that song. Oh, you know what? I found it. I found it, but I haven't, like, I don't know if I can even read it in this dark. I'm so unfamiliar with it. I can't read it. Next week when they have the lights on, I'll play it.
All right.
Here's a song that's thematic. Dancing in the dark. Say Dietz and Schwartz for some reason. Dietz and Schwartz. sing some. Trademark scale hidden in there, or not even so hidden. Yeah, there it is, not really. There it was. It's a, you know, that really helps. Lots of times I hear that, and then I it does help me know, like, who wrote it. Albums. Kathy Moses likes this one. I remember. Thank you. Rube Boom. It's one of those names you can say while you're brushing your teeth. Who was that again? No. Rube Boom.
You
can
tell that was a Mercer lyric from
yeah.
The other side of Delaware.
He's the kind of guy, if you just bumped into him in a gin mill, he'd write a song with you. Right? That's what they said about him.
He liked the drink. He really did, but he always got in trouble because he insulted everyone when he drank. So he used to, his flour bill was out of sight. He used to sell flowers and he'd say,
I'm going to take a very short break. It's only going to be 3 minutes. And if you guys are still here, I'm going to do Days of Wine and Roses. And if you're not here, I'm going to do it anyway.
Oh, I love Days of Wine and Roses.
Yeah. Courier Express. Bob is here. Oh, yeah, yeah. It's Courier Bob. He's here tonight. Oh, yeah. Boy, does he have some stories. Don't ask him about any. The stories are, you won't sleep for a month. He was the news photographer at Courier Express back when, you know, they'd shoot the guy, the dead, he shot dead guys, you know. It's Susan. Start. We got Bob and Susan. And hello to Susan's friend. Thought she came in with a friend. Maybe just happened to be somebody important looking walking through the lobby, I guess. They automatically look like stars when they're with Susan. You're off. Yeah, you're off tonight. Usually it takes more beers to get to that state. Or did you start somewhere else? You're out of shape. Oh, yeah. We turned the room over. This is like the second show. We can do all the songs again. Get Jay back. We had that all set up. Yeah, dinner theater. See, I gotta get into the key of F from here. Sometimes I'm happy, sometimes I'm blue. My disposition depends on you. We're gonna just randomly. You and me, Because it's not simple, it just sounds like it.
But every one of us is around the moment. Yeah, that's the thing. Kind of like Christmas, the same way.
Yes.
Yeah.
There weren't any hidden treasures.
Here's something from Girl Crazy. This is reality piano bar, ladies and gentlemen. Boy, the live stream is really, really delayed because earlier in the telecast, we had a slow internet connection. We must have missed a lot of frames. This is for the geeks in the audience. So we wound up like we're like 10 minutes. They're watching it like 10 minutes behind us. Now we got a good stream, so it's keeping up now, but we have 185,000 dropped frames for those keeping score. Last miracles had come and passed, when suddenly I saw you there, and the only one in town for parted. Ooh, everywhere, ooh, yeah. Oh, that sun was shining. Is there something I don't know? Some rumor going around about my health or something? Sorry, don't worry. Here's one about physics. Moment on, you for me, dear, only two for tea, dear, from this moment on. Because they know they're punched in, and I think they don't want to appear like they're strolling, or they've got a different gait. I don't think they realize they're doing it. Maybe they do. Picking out ones that are easy to read in the dark. Have you met Miss Jones? Someone said as we shook hands, she was just Miss Jones to me. Then I said, Miss Jones, you're a girl who understands. I'm the man who must be free.
at once was scared to death. All at once I owe the earth and I own the sky. Now I've met Miss Jones, and we'll keep on meeting till we die. Miss Jones and I.
Oh, yeah, he was good.
Yeah, is he great?
How many did you do?
He did two.
Neither
should
you.
The show business magic number, too.
What?
He did two numbers.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's good, though.
He's great, yeah. Yeah, he's...
Young guy, too.
He is a young guy. Especially, you know, compared to us.
I'd like to hear the young guy's son.
Good point. Unless they sing him too good. Yeah, he's the real deal. Yeah. Hey there. Are you with the stars in your eyes? Love never made a fool of you. You need to be too wise. Hey there, you with that high flying cloud. Though you won't throw a crumb to you, I think someday she'll come to you. To forget her, her with her nose in the air. She has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Oh yeah. Won't you take my advice? I hand you like a brother. Richard Adler and Jerry Ross. Courier Bob made a friend. It's good for business. Thank you, Mr. Otto. Thank you, Nick. Shilling for me. Watch this, I got push button convenience. Look at that. All the latest technology. I've got the button. Completely.
until the big affair began. Before I knew where I was at, I found myself up on a shelf, and that was that. I tried to reach the moon, but when I got there, all that I could get was the air. My feet are back upon the ground. I've lost the one girl. One girl I found. And Schwartz. What a group we have. This is a real piano bar group.
Is this like a government security clearance book here?
Yeah, we're right across from it's sort of
open it, will I?
So the guys across the street feel comfortable when they come in here. Got Homeland Security. Chance. You gotta help those young guys out, you know? You gotta help those young guys out. I know I'm organized, aren't I?
I love it.
I may be wrong, but I think you're wonderful. I may be wrong, but I think you're swell. I like your style, say. I think you're marvelous. I'm always wrong, so how can I? All of my shirts are unsightly. All of my ties are a crime. If dear in you I pick rightly, you
I think you're wonderful. I think you're grand, but I may be wrong. I may be wrong.
Singers are never wrong.
Good point.
Who wrote that, Howard? We were studying.
Henry Sullivan and Harry Raskin. Here's one. I don't know if it's cloudy or bright, 'cause I only have eyes for you, dear. The moon may be high, but I can't see a thing in the sky. There's so many ways it could be done, you know.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's a hairy one.
It is? Yeah, Neil Dubin.
Neil Dubin was the main guy. Yeah, that's it. Thanks, Howard. See you.
Thank you, Paul Kokoda. Paul Kokoda, everybody. The Janis Okun of lounge piano. He's the Grick. He's leaving happy. Seems to be. He's going to pick up a McDonald's drive-thru on the way home for his daughter. Is that right, Paul?
Oh, yeah.
It's 3 in the morning here at Lounge Academy, which is 8 o'clock to you people. Starting out. What am I gonna do? gonna laugh you right out of my life. Laugh and forget this affair. Guess I was foolish to care. So I'm gonna dance you right out of my dream. Try to be carefree and gay. I guess that I'll learn to play the part. When our friends begin their artful rumor, I know I'll really need my sense of humor. I'm gonna laugh you right out of my life. Make a beautiful joke. I never had a crowd not get sick of me. So of course, it's not me, it's the scene. And that's what we're here to accomplish, is to build the situation of critical mass where the lounge cadets cannot get enough of each other. And I'm really the catalyst. How are you? Thank you. So how are you? What a night we've had here at the Statler. Not only did we have a great, great group of lounge cadets here in the Ether audience. Judith enjoyed her first, yes? We enjoyed Judith's first, and hopefully first of many, visits to Lounge Academy. Great night. sharp in here to read. We're going to have to fly by instruments. I mean, by IFR. No, I guess it would be instruments if you can't see. We can do that.
Thank you.
60s that aired in England. This is the kind of piano bar crowd I like the best. For Kathy. It's always spring when Kathy walks into the room. Even when she brings Nick. How's Nick doing tonight? He's probably at another gig. I can't believe you guys. You guys must have like done 5 hour energy or something. Said they won't. Oh, okay. I gotcha. That was tricky. Mary's gonna go get a couple more drinks. She just remembered she doesn't have to ride the bike home. She's gotta ride. Saying, darn it, why didn't I play that? Thank you. think I'll be wiped out.
Is that
right? I said, I think I'll be wiped out.
No.
Not me, though. I've got boundless energy. That's what I keep telling myself. I'm like Nick. I've got boundless energy. If the day ever dawned, in politics. That career has been shot, been destroyed. I wouldn't even want to be a committee man or woman, committee person. What do they call them now? My parents were committee men. My mom was a committee man. That was before they had different gender affiliations. My parents were really into politics, and I know a lot of...
I studied playwriting with Manny Creed.
Oh my God.
Read all his union plays, and I always swore I'll never get involved with a union. Now I'm running.
Now you're
vice
a union.
President of the Substitute Teachers Union, which is like a kangaroo.
Holy
court.
Cow.
I know, I gotta give you a little flyer thing.
Oh, cool.
If you know any substitute teachers,
sure.
Tell them that it's like...
Look at this, she's really it is.
We, a few of us,
there's her face.
We have a slate of people and we have our own website, and it's absurd how ridiculous it is. So we're not going to win, but we're going to keep plugging.
Ladies and gentlemen, vote for Susan for president of the union for substitute
right.
teachers.
Yeah.
Amen, sisters. We deserve better. All of us.
And then if she wins, she's going to make me chairman of substitute chords.
That's right. You're going to be the head singer.
That's a music nerd joke. Well, good night, everybody. I think we can quit now. Because I see Courier Bob putting his glasses on. Oh, yeah. Thanks for tuning in to Lounge Academy. I had a great time, and that's all that matters. I'll be here again next week, because that's what we do on Fridays, right here at the Step, 107 Delaware Avenue, Buffalo, New York, 14202, Statler City. Kathy's touching the ferns. Nothing's real here. This is show business world. We got work. There they go, ladies and gentlemen of the jury. We play until every last living thing in this building is not breathing. Bye, Kathy. Thank you. Bye, Susan. Thank you. You're so wonderful to play for you.
Darling, lovely to hear you.
Oh, well, thank you.
Mary, you take
there they go.
Girl.
You take care, hon, too.
Yeah, we're going to go for Brenda's birthday.
Hey, Mary, looks like...
Yeah, Brenda's...
Looks like we're home alone now. Just you and I and 900,000 square feet of the Statler. What are we going to do?
Susan told me that my day glow color does not go well with anyone's skin tone. But I wear it anyway.
It goes good with yours.
Thank you.
Ooh. I'm still excited about those potatoes we picked out of the backyard today.
Can you believe that?
You know, those things, you were right.
I was right?
Within an hour, they were French fries, right? Because I went to work
were
and threw
really
them
in. Were they really good?
Yes. They, it
well,
it,
we're
going to
boil up the ones that we have left and just cook them gently for new potatoes. They're new potatoes.
They are a different experience because of the freshness. I never had potatoes that I washed the dirt off of and then threw them in boiling water.
I have not either.
After slicing them up.
Yeah.
And until today. And, you know, even when I cut them, the texture, it's kind of like, you know, like if you have like really fresh sushi or something, just things that are just like really fresh.
I haven't tried them yet, so I don't know. I've hoarded my carbs all day so I can try them. I drank the vodka today instead of the wine so I could try the potatoes.
I see.
So we'll try them.
That makes sense.
As I told you before, maybe I will never forget that moment when we started to dump the dirt out of the bin, I didn't think anything was going to be growing in there, and I thought,
no.
Forget it,
and
we'll
it,
just
it still
dump
didn't
this
look
this
like it. It just
failure.
Looked like somebody set a potato there.
Yeah, and we dumped it out, and this potato comes rolling out of the dirt. We had a potato. Yeah, and then we had other
they're
potatoes.
They're weird, because usually...
They're just sitting in there. They're not attached to a vine.
Usually if something grows in the dirt, everything I've ever seen is like it's attached to something. It's got dirt all over it.
This has dirt all over it.
It has, like, hair on it or something, right? But these were just like potatoes in a bag. Just saying there was with some
they
a little
really
a little bit of powdered dirt on the outside.
Yeah.
But they just like
they were clean.
They just rolled out. Like you didn't have to like
clean.
Pull them out.
They looked nice. They were clean and nice.
It was like somebody got there 5 minutes before and just put potatoes in there for us or something.
Yes,
and then
that's what it looked like.
It was a weird feeling.
It was really funny. See, so next year we're going to devote all our lands to potato farms.
It's amazing. What amazed me is how happy those potatoes are. Just sitting in the dirt. Now, the plant had already wilted and died.
Yes.
And we thought, well, we better pick them, you know, because they'll rot or something, and it's time to, they're as good as they're going to get, I guess. There's no plant left on them. And they were in there just happy, happy as a clam.
They could have been good for another couple of weeks,
right?
I think, sitting there.
Probably for months.
For months. Yeah, they're, just sitting there in the dirt.
They're just happy sitting there in the dirt. They don't like it soggy. They don't, like, things don't attach to them, bugs aren't on them, they're just, what an amazing creature.
They look like something you'd buy at Wegmans. They look perfect.
Yeah, it shows you that they don't do a thing except put them there.
Yeah.
And then we pay them.
So those grew out of the eyes, Howard, that you put in the, planted those, the eye of the potato.
All right, well, good night, everybody. That was our epilogue, the story about us picking potatoes. So we'll see y'all again. Let's see if anybody's, like, you're not going to be able to talk because the delay to the home thing is like 15, 20 minutes because earlier in the show the connection was bad, so it's spooled. So we'll say goodnight. I'm afraid to hang up. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put it on short break, but it's really not a short break because I'm afraid if I hang up here, it might not finish sending the stream to Facebook, which is delayed by about 15 minutes. So here we go. Good night, everybody.
Good night.